Beast! Ikuzo!
The Empty Throne was introduced in One Piece chapter 907, and it made us believe that the Gorosei, the five elder stars, were the ones to rule the world. In the previous chapter to that, we got introduced to Imu-sama, and the chapter after, Im-sama sat on the throne. When researching his name, you will always find connection that Im is not human. Like when written in katakana, Im's name is composed of the two radicals comprising the characters, which means Buddha, and Im is the name of a giant appearing in Norse mythology. There was one connection to his name that got me interested the most, and it connects to both Monkey D. Dragon and possibly Monkey D. Luffy. Imu-sama and Monkey D. Dragon's past, the hidden connections. Hi everyone, Flying Panda. Imu-sama and Monkey D. Dragon may be at the reverie at the same time, but is this the first time or have they encountered each other before? There was this new information on the Dragons of One Piece, magazine volume 5, that was translated and published by Arta, the Library of Ohara, which might suggest that Monkey D. Dragon was a celestial dragon. Dragon, the leader of the Revolutionary Army, is himself named Dragon. Quoting Arthur, if his name was given to him by Garb, a Marine Vice Admiral who worked for the World Government, and he gave it to him after he joined the Marines, did he give him such a name so that people associated him with the leaders of the World Government? In One Piece chapter 905, Steli asked Garb about his connection to the Celestial Dragons. Was it to imply that Steli knew that Garb was previously a celestial dragon? Now let's go back to Imu-sama's connection with Monkey D. Dragon. There's this religion called the Canaanites religion. It refers to the group of ancient Semitic religion practiced by the Canaanites living in the ancient Levant from at least the early Bronze Age through the first centuries of the Common Era. A great number of deities in the fourth tier hierarchy, headed by El and Asura, were worshipped by the followers of the Canaanite religion, and one of those gods that caught my attention, Yam, the god of the sea. Yam, or Im, is the deity of the ancient chaos and represented the power of the sea, untamed and raging. He is seen as ruling storms and the disasters they wreak. Besides the similarities with the names Im, their meanings are the same. If we reverse Im's full name in Romaji form, is Imu to Yumi, which means sea or ocean. Yam or Im, the Canaanite word for sea, is one name of Ugaritic god of rivers and sea. There's too much of a coincidence even Im and Im's Japanese spelling are similar. The idea here is that Imu equals Im, the god of the sea. Yumi happens to also be the romanized version of the Japanese word for sea, which is backwards in English, would be Imu. Yam was in constant conflict with another god, Bao, and these two gods met each other in combat on the plains of heaven, and after his defeat, Yam was cast out of heaven and into the depths of chaos. Bao in One Piece, I believe it to be Luffy, due to the name of Bao's father, Dagon. Dagon was the principal deity of the Palestinians whose ancestors migrated to Palestinian shores from Crete. He was the god of fertility and crops. As you have guessed, the name Dagon is similar to Dragon. If we look back at the beginning of this theory that Dragon is a celestial dragon, then if we remembered Rob Lucci's quote, the celestial dragons are the gods who create this world. To put it simply, the ones living here are the kings of the lower world. So it's only natural for a god like him to get everything he wants. It implies that celestial dragons are too considered gods. When we entered Wano, the Straw Hats had to climb a waterfall. This told a story about how many carp swam upstream against the river's strong current, but few are capable or brave enough for the final leap over the waterfall. If a carp successfully makes the jump, it is transformed into a powerful dragon. A Chinese dragon's large, conspicuous scales indicate its origin from a carp. This was probably the reason why Monkey D. Dragon was called Garp, to represent the carp, and his son Monkey D. Dragon was the dragon. Im fought Bao for supremacy before the creation of the world and wanted to rule. This would fit extremely well with the theory that Im was a victor who sought to erase the contents of the void century, the world before creation in the void, from existence and create the world as it is today. Maybe older mixed dragons and Bao's story, where Dragon will be facing against Im, then Luffy will be facing off against Im afterwards. Bao developed into a single widely known god called Lord of the Earth and Lord of the Rain and Dew. It's interesting this part because we always said that Monkey D. Dragon could control the weather. Or could it be that this represents for all of the D's? This has been shown by characters that seem quite wary of the storm that those with D were known to cause. Rocinante, Doffy's brother, explained to Law that the D has been secretly inherited worldwide and throughout history, and that in a certain land the family of D was referred to as natural enemy of God. In some versions of the myth, Yam and Bao repeatedly killed each other, resurrected, fight again and die, only return to life once more. This repeating methodology battle may symbolize furious winter sea storms which usually calm in the spring. Then this gave me a thought. What if Im-sama has been fighting a reincarnation of a rival for centuries? This could be why he has the straw hat in Marijuana, which was the crown of the previous king. This makes me think that Goldie Roger was next to fight Im-sama until he got an illness, or that he found out that he was not the one. Roger gave his straw hat to Shanks to keep it until he finds a person who can take Roger's place in the fight. This could have been a foreshadow when Luffy enters Wano, and in the sumo fight he was called Luffy of the Sea, Luffy no Yumi. But why hasn't Imusama aged? There has been theories and theories that the national treasure of Marijuana is not gold. It may be the option that the national treasure is Im-sama himself. This would also explain about Doflamingo's plan about Law's Opi Opi Nomi being the ultimate fruit, because it can give eternal life to someone. All leaders believe that no one could sit on the empty throne, since it's a symbol of peace and equality among the countries. Im-sama is actually the one who sits on it. Finally, more about Yam is that it was a tyrannical, monstrous deity of the sea and other water realms. Yam was in constant conflict with Bao, and these two gods met each other in combat on the plains of heaven, and after his defeat, Yam was cast out of heaven and into the depths of chaos. In the Egyptian version of the story, the monster god Yam was defeated by Seth, with whom Bao was identical in the Ugarific myth. Yam is not clearly described in available sources, and no clear appearance though, he seems to be a serpentine in form. Some believe that Yam may have been a great seven-headed sea monster in his following, or he could also himself have been that monster. There has also been theories that Im-sama created the devil fruits. Devil fruits are said to be the fruits of the sea devil, and that the secret to their power is hidden in the Grand Line. Imusama, the sea devil? I find it an interesting coincidence that One Piece could be inspired by Dagon and Bao, when Oda was himself inspired by Akira Toriyama's, who created Dragon Ball. Anyways, That's the end of the theory. What do you think? Please leave comments down below. Please hit like, and if you haven't, please subscribe to Flying Panda and join our Discord.